Today, I'm testing viral Minecraft block facts that you think are fake clickbait, but actually work and you won't believe are real. Watch until the end to have your mind blown.
Tinted glass versus stained glass. Stained glass was added in 1.12, while tinted glass was added in 1.17.
That's true. It's
tinted glass doesn't let any light through, while stained glass does. Stained glass has a range of colours.
It's still glass.
Stained glass must be broken with a silk touch pickaxe. Tinted glass blocks a beacon's light. Stained glass makes it colourful.
No! I guess we just dig straight down. All right, you can see it's pretty light here. Now we're gonna place down one of the tinted glass blocks. Bro, what? It went dark in here. Wait. Maybe the same thing happens when I use stained glass. Okay, we use black stained glass here, and the light stays. Okay, even though you can see through the tinted glass, it seems to, like, block out the light. Is it the same as if I use a full block? Oh, wait, that was sand. So if we use a full block, it goes completely dark. If we use a tinted glass, it doesn't go completely dark. Look at that, almost no light. You can't see through there at all. Whereas with the stained glass, you can see the bottom. Well, that's good and all, but does it really block beacons? I'm beginning to think maybe it does. But normally, we put down a beacon, it goes boom, up into the sky there. And if we use black stained glass, all it's gonna do is change the color of the beacon. It still passes through. Will the tinted glass stop it? It actually does. My brain is struggling to wrap itself around this concept, guys. I need a moment.
Minecraft notebooks used to look like this.
I
the plate stamp was unused for 8 years.
Really?
Most blocks can have 800 combinations.
Oh my
pressure
gosh.
Plates on notebooks don't work.
That's
notebooks
strange.
On notebooks make a string-based sound. There are 16 instruments that notebooks can play.
Jukebox,
this came a year before notebooks. Notebooks can play 25 different notes. Pistons didn't push them until 1.13. You can hear a notebook 48 blocks away. Notebooks starts as F sharp. Notebooks catch fire from lava but never burn away. Diamond and netherite break the Subscribe!
These are apparently the 16 different blocks you can use in order to get all different types of instruments in Minecraft. So the first one is if you use wool, and we place a note block above here. This is going to give us a guitar. You can hear there. Then we can place it on packed ice. We get chimes. And then we can use clay. We get a flute. I had no idea there was a flute in Minecraft. For gold blocks, you can get bells, which is really cute. Don, this is the one I think most of us know. You get a bass drum. Just like that. With glass, sea lanterns, or beacons, so basically anything that, you're gonna get clicks and sticks. So basically your snare drum, just like that. Any sand, gravel, concrete, and powder, you get an actual snare drum. So basically any block that has gravity on it. That's really awesome. And then you can combine this with any wood to get an actual bass. Just like that. Got 8 down. Now with the block, you get a xylophone with the bone here. Just like that. I really like the sound of that one. With the iron, you get an iron xylophone. Makes sense. Just like that. That's like a deeper sounding of the bells. You get a cowbell with soul sound, which is just weird ass. Like, huh? How does that make sense? Listen to this. Now, here in Australia, we have the didgeridoo. If you've never seen one of things, Google them up. They're just these giant, like, cylindrical instruments, and they sound like this on top of a pumpkin. Just like that. You can get a synth sound on a block of emerald. So you get your, like, electronic sounds just like that. And then with our hay bale, we can get a banjo. Okay, this is so far my favorite. I love the banjo, guys. And then we've got an electric piano on the glowstone. Just like that. And finally, to top it all off, you can get a harp slash a piano for any other block just like that. And this is the one a lot of us know from the default. But look at that! Just by using the different blocks, you can literally create an entire orchestra or band. On top of that, guys, though, there were a few other facts that I definitely did question. Let's place down some lava here, and then we'll just chuck down our note blocks into the outside areas here. Bang, boop, and bum. These things are made out of wood. So in my head, with Minecraft logic, they should, in fact, burn away. They should burn up. Look, only that one is setting fire. Okay, maybe we'll put it right in the lava, and they might actually set fire. Okay, so those are setting fire. We'll leave that for a bit to see if they burn away here, guys. These things don't seem to burn. I mean, this has literally been in lava here, guys, and these seem absolutely fine.
I'll break Minecraft's logic in 30 seconds. That's all I need.
Okay,
so you cannot place water in the nether, right?
Yeah, it's
too hot. You can freeze yourself to death by placing the new powdered snow. I'm just going to place it right here.
Doesn't that melt?
You'll see that you can freeze to death in the nether. We're dying from hypothermia in the nether.
Oh, this is so dumb. This is so dumb! This literally takes 5 seconds to try. Here's our powdered snow bucket. We place it on the ground in the nether. It's not melting for some reason, even though this is the literal fiery depths of hell. Break the blocks underneath. We'll switch into survival mode and we'll just walk into here. You've got to be kidding me. You have got to be kidding me. Look at my screen right now. It is freezing up. My hearts are freezing and I am dying from hypothermia. In the nether, where it's literally hundreds of degrees. Minecraft block facts, why do you defy all Minecraft logic? Minecraft is very broken. Yep, I know. What are we doing? Digging up some coal here? How is this broken, guys? We're placing a lever on the coal. Activate. Hup. Did we just... Okay, we powered the coal and turned it to redstone? How have I never seen this before? So let's chuck that lever on top of our coal here, guys. And in 3, 2, 1, ba-ba! You know why I haven't heard about it? You know why? Do you want to know why? Because it's clickbait! There were so many kids probably who tried to do this the same as me and failed. We're going to avenge them. We are exposing this guy for clickbait! And here is the culprit of the crime. A command block, guys. That's exactly how we all got clickbaited here. Basically, we needed to go ahead and figure out what coordinates this coal ore is. So we pre-planned where he was going to place the lever. We select that. You can see the coordinates here are 284791476. Now we're going to place down this command block, and it's a repeating, always active command that, as you can see, it does execute positioned on those coordinates and runs execute if it tests the block above it is a lever and it becomes powered on. It will set block the block below it to redstone ore. So it's pretty straightforward. It's a single command here, guys. And now if we place the lever on top, activate that, boom, it turns into redstone ore and we can dig it up just in survive. You can see legit redstone ore like they did in the video. If you don't subscribe, then you like clickbait. What is wrong with you? Which gives you more levels? Normal diamonds versus deep slate diamonds? That's actually a really good question. Which would give you more XP? See, in my head, they should be exactly the same. I mean, they're both diamonds. Why would one give you more XP than the other? And you can find both diamonds and deep slate diamonds on the same level. So with just normal diamonds here, you got 18 levels and 15 bars. But then with our deep slate diamonds, which in my opinion should be the same. They spawn on the same levels. They produce the same. They take slightly longer to dig up, but no, it gives you 90 levels and 2 bars. Here's the thing. Who's to say they didn't just use a command to get more XP or have a cut and use a bunch of Bololo enchantings? We just don't know. And it just doesn't make sense in my head. And also, I'm kind of loyal to the OG diamonds, guys. These are the real stuff here right now. These are fake diamonds. They've come in. They aren't the new, they're the new boys in the block. All right, I'm loyal to the normal diamonds, but I suppose we're gonna have to test it with my enchantment level 100 pickaxe. That is totally legit survival Minecraft. The normal diamonds here. All right, there we go. All right, and we can pick up all of this XP. And we've got a total of 8 levels here and almost 16 bars. 8 levels, 16 bars for 27 diamonds. Now, let's give the deep slate diamonds a little bit of a go. Oh, I should probably clip my XP first, you guys. So XP set at P0 levels so that it is fair. And we'll do the same thing for points here. Bang. All right, back to 0 XP. You can see in the bar above my hot bar. Let's dig up the deep slate. And pick up each of the diamonds. And yep. It is in fact confirmed to you guys. Look at that. 8 levels and just 1 more bar. So that's 17 bars. Okay, what are we building here? We got a piston and a copper block. Ooh, using the brand new copper blocks here. Then glass? What shape is being built right now? Why, guys? It's like a L, a upside down L? For what reason? We're breaking 1 block below each piston. Oh, it's to keep in liquid. So on one side we have lava and one side we have water. Is this just a fancy cobblestone generator? Okay, now we have redstone repeaters coming out. And honestly, guys, I'm just confused. What block fact is this? That you combine lava and water and it gives you cobblestone? I know that. I'm just so lost, guys. We've got a comparator here and a lever. We're putting glass in the middle, breaking the block at the bottom, hitting the lever and... Wait a minute. Is that obsidian? Wait, what? It creates obsidian, but it automatically breaks it for you. You don't have to sit there and mine for hours and hours on end. It just creates obsidian. I've seen cobblestone generators, but never an obsidian generator. That's awesome. I need this in my world. Oh my goodness. This is awesome. So we've got a piston and a copper block. And so it's 3 blocks across here. Okay, copper blocks above each. And then we have like this glass thing that goes up 3 blocks, comes back 3 blocks. And this is to keep the lava and water, assumably, from flowing out everywhere. And we bring that around the back and then 3 blocks and 3 blocks up. We do the same thing on the other side. Then we got to break the block in front of this piston here, in front of that piston there. And now we put lava on the left side on top of the copper block, and that should flow down into the hole. Perfect. And then water on the right side here, and that'll flow down into this hole there. Redstone repeater on each side here. That was on 3 ticks. So we go 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 2, 3. We bring out that redstone dust just like so. Bring it into the middle. Now, here's the thing. We had a comparator here and 1 redstone dust here, and this was in subtract mode. I'm assuming that makes... Okay, can we not light everything on fire? Put some obsidian around your lava side just so that it doesn't all start burning up on fire. We're on subtract mode. Now we just put a lever here and it should be done. Oh, wait, no. I almost forgot one last step. You guys would have roasted me in the comments if I'd forgotten. We place the glass blocks here. Destroy this one in the middle. Here we come. 3, 2, 1. Ba-bam. What is this? Are you kidding me?
Are you kidding me?
Guys, these pistons don't even push the liquids. Like, the water and lava are literally just stuck there. They're not even getting pushed down. Like, the water's updating for, like, a second, but it doesn't get pushed to the center. And there is no obsidian being made. I'm actually so sad, guys. I would have been so happy if this worked. We've been clickbaited, and I refuse to let them get away with it. Let's expose these buggers. So it turns out the whole thing is literally just for looks, because this machine does nothing. What does all the things are these command blocks. That's exactly how this works. And they're hidden just under our machine here. They must have put in a cut or built them below or something. But basically, if we dig under here, guys, we need to come under this piston 1, 2, 3 blocks and place down this repeating always active command block that executes if block, and the block tilde 3 above it is a piston and it is extended. When it is extended, guys, it's going to output a signal through this redstone comparator, and we got to build inward so it's underneath where the obsidian is going to spawn here, guys. And then we basically just place a block here that sets blocks obsidian 3 blocks above where it's supposed to be. And with this block facing down, we're going to go ahead and place another command block below here, also facing down, that is setting block 4 blocks above it to air and destroying it. So basically, it sets the obsidian, then it replaces it with air and destroys the item, so we've got it placing down. Now you guys can see, if I go ahead and click the lever, boom, there is our infinitely destroyed obsidian appearing there for us to pick up, looking so neat and so cool. If you want to prank your friends, why not give this a go?
Here's how you can build a working escalator in Minecraft.
Alright, I'm
firstly, listening. You want to have some sort of staircase ready. Then at the bottom staircase, place 1 honey block next to it, 2 to the left of it, and then 2 to the right of it. Build 2 honey blocks up, 4 across, and then 1 honey block here to create a rectangle.
Guys.
Then you want to fill in the back of the rectangle with any solid block.
Yeah,
then so on the top row of honey blocks, on the third block, repeat this rectangle. And then just fill in the back like this again. You could do this as many times as you want
this
for however big your escalator
brain.
Is. Now in line with the holes in the rectangle, you want to place gates to block up the holes. Open up these gates and repeat it with all the holes in the rectangle. Then what you want to do in each one of these holes is just place one water bucket.
Guys,
now that you've got water in each
one
of these honey block holes, you just
want
to shimmy
videos.
Right up to the honey block, and it should automatically pull you up to the top.
I've seen my friend Ethan do this in one of our videos, and it was really, really dope. But I still don't understand how it works, and I don't understand how to build it. Well, let's place that. It comes out like that. And then we've got to build it out 2 blocks this way up and around. So that's 3 blocks wide and cover up the back like so. And basically, we just had to repeat this over and over again, I think is what it said. Okay, I don't really know. Wait, that doesn't seem right. No, I think it's got to be one more across, guys. So there should be a space of 2 here. You repeat and repeat that over and over again. That makes sense. Okay, we'll do that one more time here, guys, all the way up. Bang, boom. And then we need to block those up with 2 fence gates here, guys, and then up here. So we need to crouch and place 1, 2, jump up again, 1, 2 to block up that space. Place the water buckets inside our honey, and then the fence gates are stopping it from flowing out. Let's give this a go, guys. All right, we got to open up. Oh, forgot. We got to open up all of the fence gates first and stand on the side here and bang. Yeah, it's literally a working escalator. I'm not even touching the keyboard right now, and it just moves you up. I'd actually build this in my survival world. But guys, for our next Minecraft block fact, you're actually gonna have to watch the next video. That's all the time we've got for today. I'll see you in the next one. Till then, anyways, stream out. Bye.